men and the women. I'm Lee McHugh. After the team competition and the individual all-around, gymnasts compete for medals on each of six apparatus for men and four for women. We begin with the women's vault, featuring Simone Biles, the individual all-around gold medalist, who also helped the Americans to team gold.
Five Olympic gold medals is the most that American Simone Biles can win. She goes for number three today in the vault finals, where no American woman has ever won gold. So here's Simone Biles. She will go in the eighth position in this group that qualified on the first night of women's competition. We start with the incomparable 41-year-old Oksana Chusovitina. Seven Olympics, no one's ever done that. That's a 28-year Olympic resume. Along the way, she's won a team gold and a vault silver. That wasn't that long ago, that silver medal. That was in Beijing in 2008. She's going up against teenagers here tonight. Your thoughts?
Well, she actually competed with my father, of course, before I was born. I got to spend a lot of time with her this summer.
Against your father before you were born?
And I spent time with her, and I said, what is it that keeps you going? And she said, nobody's making me do this. I love gymnastics.
Tim, how does she train?
Well, she does a really hard vault. It's called a Puta Nova. Watch this in training. She's doing this handspring front up onto these huge stack of mats. Now, what she needs to do after that is a whole nother front flip. That's a timer.
How does it prepare her for this?
Well, it makes her work so hard without the risk of landing low. And this vault right here has a maximum score of 17.0. Since Puta Nova, I've never seen anyone really land this. Oksana has put it to her feet, but then sat down on it as she was coming up. She needs a huge block, gigantic air, and really flipping as fast as she can. Well, that alone is a huge accomplishment because she did not sit down. But that right there, that landing, doing that forward roll out of it. So watch, she needs a giant block. And let's see, I think it might have been, it's about the same as we've seen her do in the past. She just didn't have the leg strength to fight for that landing.
She still found a way to finish it with style. Look at this. Somehow her 41-year-old knees got through that. But it's a red score, not good compared to where she could start. She had a 17 start value, and she gets a 14.933. They average the two vaults.
This vault has a 16 maximum score. And I'll tell you, that knee on that landing looked a little shaky. Remember, she is 41 years old, has a son that's a year older than American Lori Hernandez. Puts that one to her feet. She'll need somebody else, though, to really open the door and make a lot of mistakes.
Well, she looks like she's saying goodbye here, but she hasn't ruled out Tokyo. But doesn't this feel like a sayonara?
Well, you know, it might, but she has said multiple times, mostly after every single Olympic Games, this might be my last, it might be my last, and she always seems to come back.
So the average for the two vaults for Chusovitina, 14.833. Second Olympics for Julia Steingruber of Switzerland, and no Swiss woman has ever won a gymnastics Olympic medal. But I'll tell you what, in the all-around, she was hanging around fourth and fifth.
Yes, she always is.
She absolutely was, and she actually carried the flag here for the Swiss Federation here at the opening ceremony at the Olympic Games.
Oh, beautiful. The same vault that we just saw from Wang Yan.
That felt metal-like.
That was pretty good. Lots of power, good height.
Ah,
Once again, you see right off of the table, she really gets high off of the board and the vaulting table.
Big push, had just a little bit of close of the hips. A little bit bent over, but a very strong first vault.
Great score for Julia Steingruber, 15.533. She could grab the lead here if she can do it again.
So her second vault will not be as difficult. It's her maximum score of a 15.8.
It's a double twisting Yurchenko. We'll see other gymnasts later doing the 2.5 or the Aminar. She just needs the landing right here. Very nice. Once again, good power. That vault has been scoring about a 15-1 to 15-2 all week in Rio. Blocks, two complete twists around.
We have a new leader. And it's Julia Steingruber of Switzerland. For an average of 15.216, that's a pretty good number to chase, which is what Simone Biles will still do, looking for USA's first ever gold medal in vault. Maria Paseka has beaten Simone Biles.
Just last year at the World Championships, Maria is actually the reigning world champion and Olympic bronze medalist 4 years ago.
Whoa. A good landing. I don't know if her feet are over the line. Much better than she did in qualifying. These are the same two vaults that we'll see from Simone Biles. Simone will flip-flop the order, though. This vault right here, it's called a Chung Fei, named after great Chinese gymnast. Half turn on, 1.5 twist off, and that foot is definitely over that green line. She'll incur a tenth of a point for that.
Maria Paseka of Russia, a 15.266, and you see the deductions over one.
So like I said, this vault will be Simone's first vault. It's called that Aminar. 2.5 twists. It was devalued, sat it down, and it has opened this vault final up. A good ball. Definitely a 3/10 step on the landing. She can do that better, though.
She got great height in the air, but just seemed to under-rotate it a little bit.
So watch, she does this half turn on, and watch her arms swinging back to that table. You see the leg separation, though. Simone is much cleaner than this and actually has considerable more power.
And the new leader is Maria Paseka of Russia, a 15.241. It all averages out to a 15.253. And now, Simone Biles. Gold in the team. A gold that felt like her destiny in the all-around. And she'll have three more chances as the final five teammates, Ali Raisman, Lori Hernandez, her parents, all watch.
And I have seen Simone Biles do this first vault in the warm-ups about four times, and it was as close to perfect as anybody is going to get. Remember, this is the same vault we just saw from Maria Paseka.
Last time she did a vault in the all-around, she was not happy at all with it.
She says, I know I can be better on vault. And it's going to get a giant number, though.
Even with that little hop back, she is definitely going to score higher than what we have seen.
She just flies higher. That's all there is to it. All of the components you need to be able to soar, she has them. Super fast run, great technique. Watch her arms. They are lightning fast to this table. It allows her to set up for this bounce. And look at, as I said, feet together. Now, a lot of people have been talking about that, the crossed feet on the internet. Okay, judges, if you can't see it in regular motion, you're not supposed to deduct. So that should not be a deduction because they can't see that with everything that's going on. Can you see her feet crossed on this? I don't think so.
Oh, my goodness. 15.90 for Simone Biles, only 0.4 deducted.
She just needs to put this to her feet. It's once again that Chung Fei. Very complicated.
And if she can do this, she will become America's first Olympic gold medalist on this event.
And there it is. That is three for sure on her quest for five. She won the all-around by over 2 points. She's going to absolutely decimate the field here. Very complicated. Half turn onto the table. A nice block. Good form in the air. Open body. Look at very little bend in the hips on the landing and a 1/10 hop. Wow.
And there again, of course, her parents. This is becoming quite common here in Rio.
That's a gold medal kiss right there.
Think of all the great ones. Nastia, Carly, Sean, the Magnificent Seven, Mary Lou Retton. This is the first time an American woman wins a gold medal in vault, and that deserves a standing ovation. A 15.966 for Simone Biles gets the gold medal. Maria Paseka of Russia gets the silver. And Julia Steingruber becomes the first Swiss woman to win a medal of any kind in gymnastics history. She gets the bronze. So the smiles continue, and so does Simone Biles. Next time we see her, she'll be looking for number four. We welcome you to the pommel horse event final, one of six event finals for the men, one on each apparatus. One competitor is gone. It's Cyril Tomassoni of France, and he put up a very good number of 15.6. One American in the draw, and he'll come next. That is Alex Nodura, and Andrea Joyce will update us on his story. But we begin with David Balyavsky of Russia. And Tim, you look at his resume, a lot of seconds, thirds, fourths, and fifths. He could use a defining moment in a big way.
He could. He actually finished fourth, just about 1.43 out of a bronze medal. But Russia got the silver in the team, and they were ecstatic. He went back to the athlete's village, and he proposed to his girlfriend, Maria Nikelova. She did say yes.
This is actually his second Olympic Games in London. He was Russia's top all-arounder, finishing fifth in the all-around. So he's hoping for an individual medal here in Rio.
A very solid gymnast on all six events. Just to make it into the pommel horse finals when you are an all-around gymnast, that is a huge accomplishment. Very nice routine.
Get his score in a moment, but right now to update us on Alex Nodura, next up for the United States, here's Andrea Joyce.
Al, I talked to Alex Nodura's wife, Holly, a couple of hours ago. You remember her as the two-time world champion, Holly Weiss. She is back home in Arizona with their six-month-old daughter, Lila. But Alex definitely feels their presence. He has decorated his room in the athlete's village with all of the photos that Holly has sent. And Holly told me she even washed all of his gear in baby detergent before he left so he would have a memory of home. So for Alex, this is a reminder of how this Olympics journey truly has been a family accomplishment.
Yeah, and this is redemption time for Alex and the rest of Team USA. What we've seen so far from them has been disappointing.
And Alex is no stranger to making a pommel horse final. in a lot of ways, he was one of the first athletes that was locked into Team USA to make this trip to Rio because of his prowess on this event. Has tremendous ability here. Really needs to avoid any form deductions, though.
So Belyovsky's score is 15.4. That's 0.2 off of Cyril Tomassone of France.
He has won national championships, NCAA titles. On this event right here, was an alternate in 2012, had that London 2012 tattooed to his arm to remind him and inspire him on this four-year journey to make it back. Very nicely done. Has a great rhythm on pommel horse and has nice distance between his hips and the pommels. Really good so far. This is tricky here. All in combination, done really well. Occasionally has form, but this right here. Oh, ho, ho, ho.
Is that as good as he can do it?
And the best I have ever seen him do in a competition right there. You dream of that happening at the Olympic Games. He did it.
And of course, his father and coach, to be able to share this moment with him is extremely special.
But watch this right here. All kinds of traveling and turning and twisting, and he just keeps it going right here. Occasionally has form deductions, legs that separate on those, not this time, and just flies up to that handstand. Boy, he put it out there, I'll tell you.
Now, Holly, we're talking to you. Don't get nervous. Enjoy this. Okay, 15.6 is the score to beat. In qualifying, he did a 15.366. And guess what? By 1/10, Alex Nador takes over in the lead. And Lewis Smith.
He's tremendous here. He qualified second in, as I said, but in the team finals, amazingly uncharacteristic, he fell from the pommel horse, trying to do an upgraded routine. Very difficult, nice extension. There's a skill called a spindle, named after Hungarian great Magyar. Required to travel completely across the horse to show a traveling element. His dismount right here. It's a little slow. It's not a deduction.
Well, how close is this going to be?
That was good. I believe he did a little bit easier of a routine than he showed in the team finals where he fell. Nice extension, as I said. Good clearance, his hips above the pommels. Intricate single pommel work. This, as I said, named after the great Zoltán Magyar. And the dismount. I'd like to see him move a little bit faster, but really, in the rules, it doesn't say that you have to.
Oh, my goodness. Lewis Smith has taken the lead. A 15.833. Alex Nador down to second spot with three more gymnasts to go. So it does come down to those little tenths here and there once again in the final of men's pommel horse. Deep thoughts for Alex Nador. And as Nastia just said a few minutes ago, there's nothing he can do.
No, he can't.
But this might be harder, just sitting there and watching and crossing your fingers.
So we're going to look at strategy here, because he did a harder routine in the team final, and he is not doing it right here. He's playing it a little safe, as his teammate did, Lewis Smith. This is beautiful right here. Nicely done. He's the reigning world champion. And as a kid, got a bronze medal at the 2012 Olympic Games in London. Here we go. Fly up to the handstand, which he does. And the extra pirouette raises that a 10th, which in my book, I think he might need. He's already got one gold medal.
So now it comes down to, well, who knows what. But it certainly ratchets up the tension a lot. One more Russian to go.
So watch this, he just flies up to the handstand here, and it's so difficult when you're in this handstand pirouetting to go back into circles like he does. Dismount just flies up to the handstand. Watch, he'll do an extra pirouette right here that raises the difficulty by 1/10.
Okay, so once again, 15.833, and Whitlock beats Lewis Smith and knocks Alex Nadeau down to the bronze medal position. Wow. And that's how it goes with the judging sometimes, right?
Well, it does, and that was a tremendous routine, and you know what? That extra pirouette at the end, a lot of gymnasts train that, but then they, when it matters most, they don't unleash it.
Okay, last man to go. And Alex Nadeau would celebrate a bronze like any other medal.
And I got to tell you, I think he's in good shape. You know? And right there, you've got a little bit of an adjustment. Nikolai is very good on pommel horse, obviously, just making it into the finals. But you can't give away anything. His up to the handstand and right back down here. Also very nicely done. He'll do it again. Really good. Had that one little issue right off the top, but since then, tremendous, nice extended body. Really needs to fly up here, no strength. Oh boy, and that is a deduction. He does not, once again, get that D-level dismount, which will cost him about 3/10 of a point. And
he came into the qualifying competition with a 15.383.
And look at this.
Yeah,
he can realize it now. He knows the sport, obviously.
Yeah, and he believes, as do I, that he has just won a bronze medal on pommel horse. There were too many errors. And I'll tell you what, you just, you know, everybody wants to go to the Olympic Games.
Imagine everybody what they're doing at his house right now.
Everybody wants to win a medal, but if you can go out there and do the best routine of your life when it matters, indescribable.
How about that? Father to son. Awesome.
Four years he waited. Now, he was the alternate in 2012. He wanted to be reminded of that every day, so he got that logo, the Olympic logo from London, tattooed to his arm, so every time he lifted them up, he would see it.
All right, let's make it all official, as we always do, no matter how we feel.
Okay.
Zenkoff's qualifying score would not change the scene. That was a 15.383. And how about Max Whitlock? No man from Great Britain had ever won a gold medal in the sport, and he wins two in one day. And that's it. Grab all the hugs you want, Alex. Congratulations.
Sure, his daughter Lila one day will understand and be so proud of his dad today.
His mom, the mom of the child, Holly Weiss Nador, she also has enjoyed great success in gymnastics.
Prepared.
Yeah, there you go. She's a world champion on the uneven bars, missed her trip to the Olympic Games.
So he had the confidence to put the flag in his bag, and he had the ability to back it up and unfurl it. Just imagine what it's like to get all the way to the end, the bitter end, and not make London. You're an alternate. So you put that tattoo that Tin talked about, you're going to look at it every day. Every single day you're going to see it. Fast forward right now. Max Whitlock wins the gold for Great Britain. Lewis Smith wins the silver. What a battle between the two Brits. But Alex Nador wins a bronze that makes everything in Rio feel great. It's the event final for uneven bars for the women, and this could be a very close competition. The United States has two representatives. That's Madison Koshin. Dad is up there watching with her brother. And then there's Gabby Douglas. And this will be Gabby Douglas's last event of these Olympic Games, and who knows?
Quite possibly, yeah. Her last competitive event ever. She, of course, has won the 2012 Olympic all-around title. She also made the uneven bars at those games. And, you know, really, she was third in the all-around. There's a two-per-country rule. So you can only have two athletes move on to the all-around finals or event finals. She didn't get that chance, which a lot of people feel is unfair, as do I.
How do you handicap this competition here?
Well, she actually qualified into this final in third. Of course, when you make it to the event finals, it's the top eight, only two per country, but everything starts from zero. So that score, it doesn't matter anymore.
Going for the handstand, 100% is what you want to see. This is very unique on the low bar. Now right back up. Just the dismount double layout.
She hit that routine in the team final so well. And unfortunately, in an event final, when you have the top eight gymnasts in the entire world, there's no room for major errors like that.
Tim, what happens when you make a mistake so early in the routine?
Well, you just somehow try to find your way back to a good mental state. It is extremely challenging. But right off the top, the thing I like about this, though, is she is going for it. You have to hit handstands exactly. And look at that one. That's perfect. Can't do it any better. Now, this is a little more intricate, and she's going for that perfect handstand. The double layout somersault gets a lot of speed on the giant. Well, she's a tremendous champion. There is no question about it. She has a team gold from 2012 and the all-around gold, as well as her gold for the team here. I don't believe she'll factor into the medals now with that error. But like I said, I like it that she was going aggressive as opposed to trying to be just a little careful.
She had a monster 15.766 in qualification. One gymnast is gone, Jessica Lopez Oroja from Venezuela. She scored a 15.33. And this took a little while, but Gabby Douglas gets a 15.066. Again, assuming you have a competitive routine and you keep the deductions to a minimum, you get a green. A little bit worse, you get a yellow, and a real problem if you get a red. The women's all-around was so much fun to watch, constantly shifting in the standings, and Aliyah Mustafina was a big part of creating that theater.
And so far, Russia has had a great championships. The women also took the silver for the team. She got the bronze in the all-around, but she is the reigning champ. Olympic first place in London 2012. Watch this big combination. And right back up again. Beautiful.
She just has such beautiful lines, finishes, tries to finish everything in a handstand.
Had a staggering 15.933 in team final. Well, it's a super hard routine done super well.
That's Madison Koshin of the United States. She's next. A little non-competitive high five.
She just, you know, has a lightness about her. Madison Koshin does as well. This is very difficult. She scoots her feet in between her hands. And this transition right up to the high bar. She'll come right back down again. And just fly back up again. Beautiful.
And the dismount, normally we see a full twisting double back, and she adds an extra turn, a step on the landing, but very difficult.
We have a new leader, and it's Aliyah Mustafina with a very high 15.9. Who could possibly compete with a score like that? Well, time and time again, Madison Koshin has proven she can. Someone's gone before you and put up a 15.9. What happens in your head?
Well, what happens in your head is you calculate it and you know you have to be absolutely perfect to compete with that.
She's pretty good, though. She's the co-world champion from the most recent worlds. Also has that big transition right back up again. Gorgeous. Just floats. Release, nicely done. Gonna have to stick this dismount.
Bang. Could we have another one of those weird tie scenarios, or did you see a mistake along the way there?
Well, you know, she is phenomenal. She is, I love watching her do bars. It's one of my favorite things in gymnastics. She's so light, airy. It looks like such fun. Unfortunately, there were a couple of handstand positions that were a little short.
And here's that first combination right there. You see right from the top, just a little bit short on the handstand, and right back down to the low bar. Beautiful. Pack salto, and right back up to the high bar.
But this is gymnastics 101. You gotta fly high and stick the landing. Look at this. Bam!
Well, here we go. Madison Koshin is going to come up a little bit short. 15.833, that puts her second behind Aliyah Mustafina. Next up is Sophie Schäder of Germany, and the Germans have had some very good routines in these Olympics.
They actually qualified two gymnasts to the event finals on bars. Have a great team. once again. Got to hit those handstands, and that one was a little bit short. If it's a little off, it's a tenth. A little bit further from the handstand, they take three. Very difficult release done late in the routine.
Three more gymnasts still to come, so Madison Koshin finds herself in a very similar spot to Alex Nadeau. Earlier today, wondering if his score would stand up, and it did. He captured a bronze for Team USA and himself.
Great bar worker. Just look at where the skill ends, though. So she's pirouetting, and hand is down there, and it is, that is certainly at least 3/10 of a point.
Full twisting, double backflip for her dismount, and just the slightest of hops.
Sophie Shader, very impressive, 15.566. That puts her in the third spot. And there's just one more woman who can shake things up, Elisabeth Seitz of Germany. And she is in the strange position, if you want to call it that, where she could knock her teammate out of a medal.
Her teammate, Sophie Schrader, scored a 15.566. The best Seitz has done is 15.533. Long time stalwart on the uneven bars. Exciting routine.
Remember, it's key to get everything in a handstand. Beautiful release move right there.
Jam-packed. Another one right here, and then the transition. Little close to the bar on that one. Not a huge deduction, but dismount in combination. Oh, and the small step. Very hard routine and well done. I just don't know if the execution is going to be enough to factor into the medals here. Without question, Madison Koshin, she's got a silver medal because that is not going to knock her off. And Aaliyah does one of the hardest things to ever do, go back-to-back Olympic champion. So many people had written off Aaliyah. She had a number of injuries. In 2010, she was the top gymnast in the world in the all-around, tore her ACL, battled back to make the team in 2012. And over the past 4 years has just had injury after injury.
Earlier this year, she wasn't even competing in the all-around competition and was able to recover, and not just recover, but get strong enough to compete in the Olympic all-around final and event finals.
And win a medal, a bronze medal. So she went back-to-back bronze in the all-around and back-to-back gold on the uneven bars.
Here we go. 15.533. She's going to just miss knocking her teammate out of the bronze, and it was that one step at the end. That was it. So it's Mustafina for the gold with a 15.9. Madison Koshin a 15.833 for the silver. Shader of Germany a 15.566 for the bronze. But Mustafina reigns again on the uneven bars. Gabby Douglas finished in seventh. American Simone Biles has already made USA Gymnastics history with 3 gold medals in 1 Olympics. Today she goes for more, number 4. Simone and the final 5, Team USA obliterated expectations to win team gold. She then won in the all-around by an unheard of 2.1. Yesterday she took her 3rd gold medal. Her teammate Lori Hernandez, part of that team effort, of course. And wow, was her floor exercise something to remember, and her balance beam is too. What's your guess, Nasia? What would a coach say to a gymnast this good right before she goes on balance beam?
Well, you know, there's not too much to say except believe in yourself. You know, it sounds so cliche, but all she needs to do is hit a beam routine, the same one she's been doing all week long here in Rio, and the gold medal is hers.
She's so fantastic. She's so consistent. So good at everything. But it is the balance beam. And if she has a major challenge, I think it comes right at the top of the routine. After this spin on one leg, she'll do a front flip with a half twist. She's had some problems on this in training. Here it comes right here. Great. As over and over said, I get so frustrated that I never do the beam routine that I can do in practice in a competition. Another one right here. Beautiful. Oh boy, and that right there, that's a half a point. When you grab the beam. She probably hasn't missed a front tuck on beam in a very long time. She's got to get it together here because this is a big dismount. 3 skills in a row. Full twisting double.
She just told her coach Amy she was under rotated, and that's exactly what happened on that skill.
How it started. This is very difficult. You have to have tremendous leg strength and balance control.
And here's that first skill, the front with the half turn, perfect. No problem there today.
This was the next acrobatic element. Gorgeous form in the air, a great landing.
But here's where it went wrong. And as she said, she under-rotated. So she was completely straight. But you see her shoulders are just a little too far back. But that was an incredible save.
So when you put your hands down to the beam, she's under-rotated, takes a step, another one, and oh, don't touch. Ouch.
She's been so good at fighting that off.
She's got a cushion, though, because in qualifying, she scored a 15.633. I believe the next highest score was Lori Hernandez, her teammate, with a 15.366.
When your right foot slipped, your left foot almost came off the beam, too.
She and her coach are watching the replay just now on the scoreboard here in the Olympic Arena. Should have heard, and maybe you did when it was live, the collective gasp. Wow, I'm not sure we've ever seen a number like that next to Simone Biles' name. Plenty of gymnastic skill, 5 after her. 14.733. Now, how about this? Son Wevers is here in these Olympics with her identical twin sister. They both didn't qualify for this.
This is a really different balance beam routine. Watch this. She'll do a round off and then a full twisting back handspring. But what she's known for are all of her turns. And it starts right here. Beautiful.
That is so difficult to do on the balance beam. So many people do it on the floor, but I've never seen it that good on the beam.
This is a great combination here. Actually, was supposed to connect that into this front aerial, though, so she'll lose a little bit of bonus points. Now watch this. This is a triple. Oh, my gosh. It's a lot of turns. It's a different style. Watch this. Full turn. Now go the other way. And here we go. Back for a double turn. That is so hard.
Boy, the Dutch came here with a different sort of game plan, didn't they?
He absolutely did.
She is just so stunning to watch on this event.
She had the second highest maximum potential score, a 16.6 in the qualifying. Unorthodox dismount right here. It's called a gainer back salto in the laid out position with a full twist.
Her reaction says she left it all out there.
It was pretty darn good.
And could she post a score that would stun the gymnastics world higher than Simone Biles? Lori Hernandez of the United States, still to come.
So she starts off with a bang. A lot of gymnasts just jump up. She does this cartwheel type skill and then a back handspring with a full twist. Very nicely done.
And here was one of those turns, a triple turn on the balance beam. It is so incredibly difficult to do. It's only 4 inches wide.
More spinning here, beautiful turn. But to do this at the very end of all, oh, crazy good. Just gorgeous. Shades of Betty Aquino did that triple turn on the beam years ago for the USA. Here's the dismount, a bit unorthodox. It's called a gainer back layout with a full twist.
After her dismount, she went right over and grabbed that book. I can only guess that it's some sort of diary.
Well, actually, what she's doing is she's calculating her beam routine to make sure she gets the proper start value, the maximum score.
In qualification, she got a 15.066. That would be good enough to take the lead for now.
Yeah, she's going to take the lead with this routine, I imagine. It was gorgeous. It was artistic. Beautiful presence on the beam.
Just an absolutely stunning development here on balance beam. Sanne Wevers of the Netherlands gets a leading 15.466. It was the kind of mistake we haven't seen from Simone Biles on her journey to these Olympics. And now she'll watch the scoreboard like everybody else. Now, she can still win a medal, but this is what caused the major disruption in the force. It looks like, and she's done this so many times, she's got it saved, right? No, she doesn't. She may have been writing down her start score, but I'm going with Dear Diary. I'm leading the Olympics. Back after this. So in a completely unpredictable event and something totally uncharacteristic, Simone Biles touches the beam with hands that leads to a series of deductions, and now she's been passed by the very unlikely Sanne Wevers of the Netherlands.
And Lori Hernandez is great on this event. She qualified in second place just behind Simone Biles.
Here's a big acrobatic sequence right here, three in a row. Very nice, indeed. Great form, locked legs, excellent toes.
Just the dismount left here.
Wow. Old Bridge, New Jersey is up and roaring at the possibilities here for 16-year-old Lori Hernandez, who's lucky enough to have her parents and her teammates in the building.
Longtime coach Maggie Haney.
I'm so proud of you.
Thank you for coming.
No, you got it.
Remember that picture we showed you just a short while ago.
And here's that combination of three skills in a row.
And the dismount, beautiful double pike, and just the smallest little adjustment. This was a tremendous routine. I think it's going to be very, very close. And that is Lori Hernandez. Wow. Most moms can't watch their daughters on balance beam, whether it's a level three or an elite competing in the Olympics.
Gabby Alley and Madison Koshin, standing ovation for that. Okay, score to beat is 15.466. She's done that. I don't mean today, but she's done it.
Balance beam judges at this Olympic Games. On a whole, the panel has just been slower. The judges rotate through the different competitions, but there are some that are on every competition, and they've really taken longer than the other events to get that final number.
And Lori Hernandez comes up just a little bit short. She'll be in second place and in very good shape for a medal, but a 15.333 comes down to one of the most popular gymnasts we have seen in this building in these Olympic Games. She's from Brazil.
Her most challenging right here. Really bounces the beam well. Oh boy. And a mistake, but looked at one point like she was either gonna come off or grab the beam as Simone did. Beautiful. Very difficult leap combination. Here's another acrobatic element. Oh, baby. And she was supposed to connect that into a leap.
That's
Speaking of connections, this connection is so difficult. She nailed it night one, three elements in a row.
Well, it was great, but in her dismount, double pike.
Flavia Sareva of Brazil. Well, now Simone Biles is sitting there in bronze medal position with a 14.733 and a major deduction. Do these deductions in your mind, Nastia and Tim, win her a medal or not?
This is going to be really, really close. You know, you got individual opinions out on the floor. They got to come to a relative consensus. But right there, she is your Olympic gold medalist. Wow.
We talked yesterday how strange things happen in the event finals, and sometimes those strange things become memorable things. And this is memorable for a lot of reasons. The Simone Biles mistake, this first individual Netherlands gold medal ever in the sport.
I think the gold and silver standings right now are going to stay exactly where they are. It just comes down to whether or not the score is 14.733 or above. That is what Simone has.
Well, I mentioned she has an identical twin. But now suddenly they're not so identical. And there she is.
And she's got nothing to worry about. This is a battle for the bronze right here. She gets to say something that hasn't been said in her country for a long, long time.
And here we go. Flavia Sareva is going to just miss a medal. So the Netherlands, Sanne Webers gets the gold. Lori Hernandez there can celebrate a silver. And amazingly, Simone Biles hangs on with her 14.733 to take the bronze. Wow, that's going to be a gold medal celebrated by the Netherlands for a long time. It is a last day to grab some prestige in the sport of artistic gymnastics. It's the men's parallel bars final, and no one knows more about what I just said than Danelle Leyva in these Olympic Games. Tim, how would you describe what Team USA men have been through?
Well, it's been a disappointment without any question. You know, Danelle, he fell in the team final on high bar, and really the only saving grace has been Alex Nador winning a bronze medal with a routine of his life. But I don't think there's a guy on this team that would say it's been all rosy and exactly the way we planned. But tonight, on both parallel bars and high bar, Danelle has a shot to win a medal. He's a world champion on this event. That's critical. Keeps his legs together, which is good for him. Has a very different style. Not the big release skills. Good fight on that. This is pretty good. There's one more swing to a handstand. Needs to land right in the handstand and does. Dismount. Oh, my!
Danelle won a bronze medal 4 years ago in London, but he said, yes, it was great. I won an Olympic medal, but at the same time, it wasn't the color I wanted.
It's his dad, Ian Alvarez, back on the podium with his cheering and chanting and clapping.
Beautiful.
Tim, is it a problem that he went first?
Well, yes. In gymnastics, the judges tend to get a little bit looser as the competition goes along. But he sent out a shot around the world right here that this is a contending routine because there were so few errors in it. Just a small hand movement right there early on. And then this skill, look at how he's on one bar.
and all the way down to the last skill on the dismount, we keep saying how important it is to stick the landing, and he does.
That was really a tremendous set. Don't know if I've seen him do quite that good ever.
That's a big one. 15.9, and he's into it.
Come and catch me if you can.
And up next to compete is Oleg Vernayev of Ukraine.
You see that little arch? That's a 10th. And a little bit of an adjustment there. His routine goes on for days, though. And another big arch right there. That could be up to 3/10 of a point. Here's his Bopsar. Just look at how he flies right there. Look at how so above the bar. One of the best ones in the world right there. A lot of little arches in these handstands, but his leg form is fantastic. Dismount. And bam!
Okay, so you get a feeling if he's going to flirt with a medal, it may be the bronze.
Well, I don't know, because Daniel Leva, his maximum score was a 16.9. Oleg's routine, a little bit harder. He's got a cushion of 17.2. Remember, he had a couple of those arches in his routine, but you want the judges to remember this right here. If it's so great, the dismount, last thing they see, spots the ground, bam! He got that.
And it is not. It is a gold medal worthy 16.041 for Vernayev. That stuck landing counts so much, and Daniel Leva moves to the silver medal spot. But it does knock China off the podium. They are not going to win a medal here. And here's the last man to go, Ryohei Kato of Japan.
And before he even starts, the men at the top of the list right now, they have a cushion because Kato only has a 16.6 maximum score here. And you know, Japan has just been ecstatic here. They have chased the Chinese for so many years. They defeated them at the World Championships last year, and then, oh, look at that struggle right there. They won the team championships a little bit short of the handstand. But since King Kohei won the all-around, Japan has looked off their game. Kenzo Shirai, who was as close to a guaranteed gold on floor as you can get, didn't even medal. And right here, nice release. Another arch of his back. Dismount. Good, but that should not factor in. Oleg Vernayev, for certain, is your gold medalist. And Leva, my opinion, no question about it, he's got another Olympic medal.
So, Tim, where did Ryohei go wrong?
Well, you know, what it comes down to is he doesn't really have the hardest routine out there. Oleg's routine, much more difficult. He only has a maximum score of a 16.6. And he opens the door because he's got some body position issues. And as we say over and over again, you know, you get to the end of the routine, you got to stick the landing.
Kato gets a 15.233. So the standings are as they were. And Yin Alvarez screams for a silver medal for his boy. Vernayev gets the gold, and Belyavsky takes the bronze, and that is the story on the parallel bars. Men's gymnastics ends on a high note on the high bar, an eight-man field that includes two Americans. Sam Mikulic, who's trying to salvage something out of these Olympic Games, and Danelle Leyva, who is trying to follow up what was a very impressive silver medal on the parallel bars. And Tim, as I look at the field, it feels like an all-star game.
It does, and I'll tell you what, fasten your seatbelts and secure your lap bar, because this is going to be a wild ride. And it starts right here. Gorgeous.
Fourth Olympics for Fabian Hambüchen.
Another phenomenal routine. Right from the start. He got a bronze in 2008. Settled for silver in London. And would like nothing better than to keep the progression going. I'll tell you what, this is a phenomenal routine. Oh, oh my, oh.
All he's thinking about at this moment has to be that step.
It all came down to this dismount. Two flips in the air, two twists. He had it, and then a slight step back and another one. That'll cost him 0.2 of a point.
Still a good score, 15.766, but Fabian Hambüchen right now is thinking about what might have been. I mentioned Fabian started in Athens 2004, and it's a four Olympic march to this moment. And I feel like we've all watched him grow up, because we have. Back then, he wore glasses. He was the youngest German at the age of 16. But between then and now, the mission has always been the same. Now, one of the most spectacular men on the high bar. You will see he's the Olympic gold medalist, and he's brought out his country's royalty. King Willem Alexander and Queen Maxima are here a day after the gymnastics team from the Netherlands yesterday, the women, got their first ever individual medal. Zonderlin would love to follow up with that.
He's the reigning Olympic champion on this event. Suffered a concussion last year. Really took him out for quite a while. But in Rio has been great. What he does better than anybody is he combines the super hard releases together. And I'll tell you, that was a little bit of a nasty fall, as you're gonna see here. Tremendous height, and this is just too far from the bar. Can't get his hands all the way around.
And unfortunately, that will knock him out of medal contention.
But look at this, he is going to finish. He's not done. Is a high bar man for the ages, revered all over the world. A phenomenal gymnast.
And there's a lot of what might have been to go around. Tim, with the extra steps of Hambüchen, the fall of Epke Zonderland, you have a feeling that an Olympic door has opened for someone like Sam Mikulic?
Well, the door is open. It's just, are you going to walk through, run through? And that is what Sam Mikulic really needs to do. In Rio, he has done an easier high bar routine to be a little more consistent. Can't do that today. Here's the added part. Really nice. Another one. Handstand. Really nice. Oh, fingertips. Does that as well as anybody in the world. One more handstand. It's just the dismount. The routine he has been searching for.
Is Sam going to be the man?
Well, you got to give him props there because he sure went for it. So he took this skill out under the advice of Mark Williams, head coach, to be more consistent. He knew he needed it to have a chance in the finals. And without question, he's going to have a chance. The only thing really in the whole routine was this small little hop right there, but that's only a tenth. This should be a very big score.
It is a 15.4 that puts Sam Mikulic in medal contention. Danel Leyva of the United States, his teammate, is still to come. So here are the standings now. With one gymnast to go, the United States is going to get a medal, and it's either going to be Sam Mikulic or Danel Leyva getting set to mount the bar.
Already earned himself a medal, but he is hoping for a different color here.
This is one of my favorite things in gymnastics. Double flip over the bar. Watch, he's gonna throw his arms off to the side. Another release right here. Bent his elbows on that giant. That's a deduction. Don't think he needed to either. Missed this in the team final. Not today. He was able to stick, and that won him a silver medal a little while ago.
Well, Dad, Yin Alvarez is really into it, but he always is. Body language says disappointment at the moment.
But watch how high he is above the bar, and then look at him toss his arms out to the side. It's so beautiful. The thing he wishes that he could take back. Probably the only thing. It's a great dismount, spots that ground. And a small hop, that should be only a tenth of a point. I think he's gonna get it though. I think he's gonna factor into the medals.
It's a double silver day for Danel Leyva, 15.5. Sam Mikulic not off the podium, but there you go. What a perfect Olympic collection for Fabian Hambuchen of Germany. He's got a gold to go with his silver and his bronze. It is the final event in women's gymnastics, and some would say it is its most beautiful. The women's floor exercise final, and easily in the top eight, Simone Biles and Ali Raisman-Nastia could star in this event. What are you thinking as it's about to begin?
Well, they absolutely could. Simone, of course, qualified into the event finals in first place. Ali right behind her. Ali, being the reigning Olympic champion, is hoping to defend her title.
And now from Great Britain, Amy Tinkler.
Her countryman, Max Whitlock, won a surprise gold on this event on the men's side, in addition to his gold on the pommel horse. And she can tumble.
Well, we still haven't seen a 15-level score. Did we just or not?
Well, she definitely had high-level difficulty. I think this will be up to the judges. We'll have to wait and see. But this opening tumbling pass, again, the same one we saw earlier, the same one we'll see from Simone Biles coming up next. A double layout, two flips in the air, and a full twist. And you see she piked down a little bit on that landing. You want to see her keep her hips straight all the way through.
Amy Tinkler takes the lead, 14.933. Well, we're about to see Uber gymnastics, and I don't mean Simone Biles is taking a car somewhere. It's just gymnastics at a higher level. And now Simone Biles, floor exercise. She's been doing the same routine for a long, long time, and when she nails it, which she normally does, it's just fun in every way, from a gymnastic sense, from a dancing sense, from a choreographic stance, from a music stance.
She sets herself apart because she makes everything look so easy. We've seen some of these tumbling runs. You won't see them done like this, though.
once again obliterate. Seems like the right word.
Power and dynamics that take your breath away. Like I said, at the top of the routine, you'll see other people that do similar elements. Nobody does as much difficulty packed in, but more than that, nobody does them anywhere near like this. Watch that double layout with a full twist, and her body remains board straight, just a slight slide back, but wow.
And her second tumbling pass is actually named after her, the bio. She was the first in the world to complete this skill, a double layout, and at the very end, she does a half turn, spots the landing into an immediate jump.
And she also knows how to play to a crowd. And her teammate, check this out. Lori Hernandez doing a little bit of Simone right there. The last pass was a full twisting double back, and she's just got so much power, as you said, uber power, Al.
Forget 15, she's up near 16. 15.966 to easily take the lead by over a point.
We believed coming into Rio that Simone could win 5 Olympic gold medals. She stumbled yesterday on beam, but that one just about perfect.
No matter what happens now in women's floor exercise, Simone Biles is going to get her 5th Olympic medal. Allie Raisman trying to do what happened in the all-around, be right up near the top with her. The final 5, Team USA has had a great Olympics. And I'm sure Rick and Lynn, who just absolutely agonize over every second, will probably do the same thing here today. Teammates here, Madison Koshin, Lori Hernandez, Gabby Douglas, gold medalists here in the team event.
And Allie, of course, is the reigning Olympic champion on the floor exercise.
Her longtime coach, Mihai Breston.
That routine, it absolutely guarantees her a medal, but we'll just have to wait and see which color.
You dream of going to the Olympics. You dream of winning a gold medal. She's already got 3.
We did it. Good job.
And you dream of doing the routine of a lifetime. If she was going to compete with Simone, She absolutely needed the best routine of her life, and I think that that was it. Her first tumbling run, jam-packed with difficulty. So watch all of the elements she does in this powerful opening run, and that she can fit this on a 40 by 40 floor. Watch now, rebound into a layout and stays in bounds. Tremendous.
Lynn and Rick again. Yeah.
I saw Mihai gesture her up on this pass, Allie. Double layout, and boy, did she listen. Watch the height. It just keeps going up, and bam!
And in this moment, on her final tumbling pass, she knew she had exactly what she needed to secure a medal on this event.
Allie Raceman gets a 15.5, and this is going to be the most successful women's team in Olympics history. So Amy Tinkler of Great Britain is going to get the bronze. But the headline here is that Simone Biles and Allie Raceman do it again for the gold and the silver. And they're going to play the Star Spangled Banner in the Olympic Arena again in a little while. Well, that is going to bring us to the end of gymnastics competition and the end of the Marta Caroli era. Her and her husband and their legacy should be etched in stone for what they did for USA Gymnastics. And there was once a Magnificent Seven, and there was 4 years ago a Fierce Five, and now here a Final Five. A Final Five that delivered more medals than ever. 9 Olympic medals. This will be remembered as one of the greatest dynasties in gymnastics history.
So Simone Biles and Allie Raceman go 1-2 in the women's floor exercise, just as they did in the all-around. That concludes our look back at the gymnastics individual apparatus finals from Rio. It was an Olympics where American gymnasts won 12 medals, twice the amount from London 4 years earlier, and 4 gold medals. Thanks for watching Return to Rio.